Good afternoon, students. In this video, I give you summary for the poem On the Grasshopper and Cricket. On the Grasshopper and Cricket. Chapter 8. It is written by John Keats. It is written by John Keats. It is not a story poem. The grasshopper is a symbol of hot summer here in the poem. Okay? Cricket is a symbol of very cold winter. Grasshopper, cricket, these two are insects that you know, right? Every poet has found great beauty and poetry in spring and fine weather. Keats is different. He finds nature beautiful in all seasons, not excluding the hot summer and cold winter. Let me read few lines, then I tell the summary of the stanza of this poem. Okay, you have to listen. The poetry of earth is never dead. When all the birds are faint with the hot sun and hide in cooling trees, a voice will run from hedge to hedge about the new mown mat. The earth is always full of poetry. On a hot summer day, the birds hide in the cool trees and go silent. But the poetry or music of the earth goes on. You can hear a grasshopper's voice as he flies from hedge to hedge about a new mown mat. Here, hedge means fence of plants, okay? Faint means unconscious. Mat means meadow, grassy land, okay? Next, that is the grasshoppers. He takes the lead in summer luxury. Luxury means enjoying the pleasures here, okay? Enjoying the pleasures of summer. In summer luxury, he has never done with his delights, for when tired out with fun, he rests at ease beneath some pleasant weed. That voice is of a grasshopper. He is in the front of those creatures who enjoy the summer pleasures. He is never tired of his pleasure trail. When tired with fun, he rests beneath some pleasant weed. That is the meaning. Okay. Next, the poetry of earth is ceasing never. On a long winter evening, when the dust has wrought a silence from the storm, there shrills the cricket song in warmth increasing hour. Ceasing means ending. Lawn means lonely. Frost means ice. Wrought means brought. Shrills means loud, high, unpleasant sounds. The poetry of earth never stops. The frosty winter evening looks lonesome and silent. Suddenly, a shrill sound comes into the ears from the stalls. It is the cricket's voice. The warmer it is, the shriller is the cricket's noise. And seems to one in drowsiness half lost, the grasshoppers among some grassy hills. Drowsiness means a state of being drowsy. Half lost means half asleep. To a drowsing person, the cricket's shrill cry may appear the grasshoppers were coming from some grassy hills. Okay? Let me tell you the summary once again. The earth is always singing. The birds stop singing in the hot summer. They seem to have fainted in the hot sun. They hide themselves in cooling trees. At that time, a grasshopper can be seen flying from hedge and singing delightfully. He sings tirelessly. When tired, he rests beneath some weed. The birds are silent in very cold winter too. Then the earth expresses its pleasure through different beings. On a frosty winter day, there seems to be utter silence. Then suddenly, this silence is broken not from the trees, but from the stones. It is the song of a cricket. The song seems to be increasing in warmth every moment. The people hear it in their houses. To someone half asleep, it may seem to be a grasshopper's song coming from grassy hills. Okay, dear students, this is the summary, and you have to learn this. You have to prepare for the exam. Okay, thank you.